Interesting orchid that we found on the ground, a terrestrial orchid in the forest here in Valle del Cauca department. This is Galeandra bayrischi, which is a very interesting plant in the sense that it has no leaves, or no visible leaves at least, or clearly visible leaves, because we searched for them a lot of times, and even when the plant stopped blooming, and when then there are no leaves getting out of the ground. So what I suspect is that the bracts that are involving the flower stem could be photosynthesizing for the plant. Or another possibility would be it's a mycoheterotrophic plant parasiting fungus on the ground. We don't have any concrete answer until now. Some people, I think, are studying this fact. This is a very nice plant, widespread in South America. And it's interesting also in the sense that this genus, Galeandra, is normally more from Amazonia and from lowlands. And this is the only species, as far as I know, that grows until almost 2,000 meters high in some places. So what is very special with orchids, about orchids for me, is their diversity. It's the main plant family in the world, so there are plants from some millimeters to some many meters high, flowers also from very small size to very big size, and the colors and the patterns of the colors, that's so diverse, and also the scent. Many orchids are scented, sometimes very bad, sometimes very heavenly scented. So these are the things that passionate me about orchids. And also, most of the time orchids are in the very conserved habitat. So if you go to see orchids in the wild, you can see many other plants, birds, animals. So it's like to go in a conserved forest, and you can see so many things apart from orchids too. So that's something that's very interesting with orchids. Farallones de Cali is a very special region because it's very rich in biodiversity. It's the biggest national park in southwest Colombia. And it's going from 200 meters high on the Pacific side to 4,100 meters high. So it has a lot of climates and a lot of diversity in plants, animals, etc. Many different kinds of ecosystems too. And it's also mainly unexplored. So when you come to Farallones de Cali, you can see many plants that are not described or not very well known. To me, it looks like a little bit like prehistoric sometimes. Also, the high cliffs in the higher part, and so many forests with big trees. I mostly go alone to explore, or sometimes with some friends. But then, if I go with people from outside, or foreigners, or people from other regions of Colombia, or even from local areas, local tourists, it seems to make them discover this high biodiversity of Colombia and of Valle del Cauca department and Farallones de Cali, for example. Although I guide in the whole country. And so it's like showing all this diversity and how life is incredibly diverse and important to conserve. And I'm really satisfied when people are happy living from my tours, and it makes me feel like I'm doing something good for society in some way too.
So here we have the same species we saw before, the Epidendrum catillus. But what's interesting here is that the plant already bloomed, and then on the flowering stem, which is terminal in Epidendrum generally, we have new growth, new plants growing with new roots and new stems. And in the orchid world, we call this cakey. At least for orchid growers, this is called the cakey. So this is a new growth, new stem, new plant with roots that you could grab and quit from the stem and cultivate or put in the forest in another place. So it's like a vegetative propagation. And just under this Epidendrum, we can see that there's an anthurium, which is a very interesting species too, Anthurium pedatum, which is an endemic species from Colombia, and very nice lobed leaves in the forest in its native habitat. It's not blooming yet because it's a young plant, but then you can find some plants that are much bigger than this one in this forest. Now here we found another Anthurium pedatum, which already bloomed, so we have the rest of the flowers, and it's been fruiting. And so we can clearly see the spat, which is separate from the spadis, which makes the difference between anthurium and philodendron, for example, as philodendron have a spat which involves much more the spadis. So here we have a seed, still have a seed into it. So as this is a group of flower, generally there are more seeds coming. So they're not all of them are pollinized. Sometimes you just have some flowers that have been pollinized, you have some seeds from one place or the other of the spadis.
It's mainly very important to conserve habitats, ecosystems, because it protects orchids but also all the life that it's included in these ecosystems. And orchids are also important because they are bioindicators. So if you have orchids or special orchids and a lot of diversity of orchids, it means that the ecosystem is conserved, because orchids are very sensitive to environmental changes. So it indicates that the ecosystem is in a good state. So to me, it's very important to use orchids to show that to monitor if ecosystems are well conserved, and also to protect the whole habitat. Also, growing orchids can be a tool to complement orchid habitat conservation, but to me it's just a small part of conservation. Really, the importance is to conserve the whole diversity of plants, because if you grow orchids, you generally select orchids that are interesting for horticulture, for people, for humans, but then you have some varieties or some species that are eye-catching, but then there are many other orchids that maybe are not as eye-catching but are as important for an ecosystem than the eye-catching orchids, for example.
These are seeds of the orchid. It's like just a powder, and so tiny. So some crazy botanist or people of laboratory once made a count of how many seeds there could be in a cattleya seed pod, which are very big. Mm-hmm. And one of the very famous orchids, and he evaluated that there were 3 million seeds in one pot. So at least hundreds of thousands.
Wow.
Well, I think as orchid passionate or experts, we cannot only concentrate on orchids. Of course, this is the matter that we are more busy on. But I think we have to be interested in the whole diversity of a forest, of an ecosystem, and become more like naturalists, and also understand the relationship that orchids entertain with other being livings, like insects, fungi that allow them to grow in the forest, to germinate. There are predators that can be feeding on orchids, and of course, as passionate, we say, oh, that's a shame, but that's not a shame, because it's life. So we have to be aware that all these relationships maintain a balance in the ecosystem. So orchids are very important as endangered or very localized plants, but there are many other plant families that are in this case understudied, endangered, on the verge of extinction now. And so we have to be aware that even if we are passionate about orchids, it's much more in life than orchids. And that's the center of our interest. But let's look at birds, at insects, at mammals that live together, and try to conserve the whole community. I think it's important to try to rescue orchids, for example, to study them. So a true rescue. I mean, not going and grab orchids from trees which are alive, and there's no threat on orchids because they are in a nature reserve, in a well-conserved place. But there are always plants that fall on our fallen logs, fallen trees, twigs with twig epiphytes, which are very small. And so if we found them fallen on the ground, of course, in nature, nobody will rescue them, will save them. So they would die and become part of the biomass and become like a compost for the forest and trees to continue to grow. But as many of them are endangered or on the verge of extinction, I think it's important whether to collect these fallen plants and relocate them in the same ecosystem or very close to these ecosystems to help these ones. Like some people help turtles to reach the sea, because, okay, some people say don't do this because it's not natural, but human is making so many damage to nature. I think now we have to do something. We cannot just stay and stare like this and see, looking at what's happening. So I think we have to help endangered orchids and other living beings.
So here we have a very famous orchid for people who are passionate about them, which is a Dracula orchid, Dracula chestertoni or kirstertoni, if you pronounce it with a K, C-H is a K in Latin, and it's an endemic species from Colombia, just existing in Colombia. And it's from the group of the monkey orchids, but this one is very special because it has a very big lip, which reminds me to a kidney. But you can also see like a small face inside of the flower. So it's in a cloud forest, cold climate. And it's very interesting to see it in the wild. And what's very nice is the plant is very big and the population is healthy. So I'm hoping that it stays for a long time in this forest with a good presence of this species, which is just unique for Colombia.
Definitely.